Hello, Foxtrot64 here again, back with more Pokemon XD Gale of Darkness version. We are so close to the end of the game. I would say there would be no more than maybe three or four more episodes after this. This is a proper research facility, sweetie. A little guy like you shouldn't be in here. Yeah, but the thing is that I should, because no one else is gonna, like, do anything about this except me, for some reason. That never made sense to me. Like, the only people opposing any kind of threat to these evil crime syndicates and everything are always, like, 10-year-old little kids. Shouldn't, like, I don't know, the adults be doing something about this? These problems? I mean, there's crime syndicates plaguing, like, every single region that there is in Pokemon, sometimes more than one. You'd think that, you know, the authorities would step up their forces a bit and take charge and do something about it instead of a little kid. Of course, again, questioning the logic of a Pokemon game. And I'm not gonna complain, I like fighting against these guys, you know. They have, like, awesome battle themes and stuff that I can listen to, so that's nice. But it just makes no sense, and it's kind of funny. And sometimes, like, in the game, they'll even acknowledge it, too. Oh, I hate to ask this of you, but I know no one else is gonna be able to do it. Oh, okay, well. That's a little bit unsettling. That you're relying on a 12-year-old to solve your problems because no one else is more capable for the job. That's okay. I give no fucks, I guess. Chime ago. I think that's a- oh, nope. I thought that was a shadow Pokemon. I thought I remembered that being it. I guess not. Either way, that Chime Echo is a sitting duck right now. I only have a freaking ghost dark type and a fire dark type sitting out here. Yeah. If you'll notice, the levels are going up a little bit faster in this place than they usually do in other areas. And that is because it is the final area. So, remember when I said I'm out-leveled, but that won't be for very long? I wasn't kidding. I'm out-leveled, but that won't be for very long. In fact, towards the end of this, actually, I might be under-leveled for the very end, which usually that is the case. You know, because that's what the challenge in it is. Otherwise, the final battle would just be fairly easy. But I might have to avoid that, actually. For very good reasons concerning the final battle. I'm not gonna spoil it for anyone, but for what I'm planning to do, I definitely do not want to be underleveled. So I'm gonna have to go back to Mount Battle probably at some point and go through area, I don't know, 5 now, I think it is, a couple times. Hello, Kyle. I'm sorry for losing so easily. Aw, you can't blame yourself. It's not your fault that you suck. You can't help it. And nobody can persecute you for that. Nobody should persecute anyone for sucking. Sorry. Ever. Alright. Let me rearrange really quick. Make sure that we're in the correct order here. We almost are. Okay. So you assault a Mystique. This next battle should be pretty easy. What are you doing? Are you cloning yourself or some shit? Doctor, we can generate even bigger waves this way. Isn't it great? Sure. So, I guess this is where they're making, like, all the ocean waves and storms and stuff. This is the machinery for that. What happens if we go in here? I don't see any items in here. Something tells me that there's battles in here, though. We've got good waves going again today. From the island, it keeps others away. Isolated is how we want to stay. A whirlpool is created when water currents collide. Try it when you're taking a bath. It'd be nice if I took baths anymore, but I haven't taken a bath in years. I've just been showering. We don't get to see too many kids here. Are you a child of one of our research people? We were responsible for keeping Citadark Isle ringed with vicious waves. Thanks to this place, it's not easy for ships to approach Citadark Isle. Yeah, I was right. This is where they're making all the storms and stuff. Hello, 5 Ultra Balls. That's nice. I'm gonna need those. We researchers are honored and happy to serve Master Grievel. Our research funding is even more than generous, and it's incredibly fun to create giant waves. I bet. With your big toy there. Oh, someone's guarding the elevator. Can I, like, slip past? Yes, I can. Okay, and go in here and... Yes. Thank you, game, for allowing me to do this. Now, can I slip past again? Go in here. Yes, but there's a battle right there, so it doesn't really matter. Yeah. Alright, what do you got? I'm sure it can't be anything too difficult. An Absol and an Injask. Well, the Absol might be a little bit of a pain in the butt. But not too much. And only so because I have a psychic type out. But Absol isn't even, like, strong by any means. Alright, so an Ice Beam should take care of the Ninjask, and the Hyper Beam on the Absol, because why not? If you've got powers, flaunt them. Just abuse the hell out of them, at least in a video game. If you have power in real life, please do not abuse it. That is called government. Government isn't exactly the most liked thing in the world. Far from it. Especially certain governments. I doubt that the American government is on, like, the top 10 most hated governments that there is. Somehow I doubt it. I mean, there are plenty of countries that are far worse off than we are, as far as that goes. So, we don't have that much to complain about, really. Don't get me wrong, there are definitely some problems and issues going on, but compared to the rest of the world, we got it pretty good. You know, so if you take that into consideration, we don't have it so bad. Granted, it could be much better, but we don't live in a perfect world. We gotta just take what's given to us, for the most part. And I'm not saying, like, be submissive and don't stand up against, you know, the big guy, but in reality, you know, there's not always a whole lot that you can do. Sometimes you just gotta accept it. Okay, no, I definitely do want to have sea salt use water pulse, then I'm gonna switch out Mystique for Bloodless to take out that Mawile right nice and quick. I've actually gotten over wanting to call Bloodless Bloodstone now. That hasn't happened in a while. Alright, get that Absol out of there. Yeah. Mystique wasn't going to be very much use to us. And Mystique gained a level anyway, so that's fine. We can just disclude him from here on out. Wow, you wasted a turn on that? Well, sucks for you! I really don't know what to say at that point. I mean, like, when you waste your last turn on that, and you know it's gotta be your last turn. Then again, I guess the AI on the grunts, so to speak, is not expected to be that great. I lost after talking big. How humiliating. Oh, it is. When you trash talk and then you lose. I hate that shit. Okay, what's in here? What's in here? 2 full restores. Nice. Alright, let me rearrange and then we're gonna go battle that person in front of the elevator. Alright, we're all set. We're right in the middle of putting the finishing touches on our Shadow Pokemon plan. We don't need your meddling! Oh, but the world needs my meddling. Litnar. Whatever the hell kind of name that is. Litnar, is it like Litner? Lightner? There's no way to pronounce that that sounds correct. It's just so bizarre of a name. I don't know, man. I'm so not looking forward to tomorrow morning. I have to get up earlier than usual and take the bus again because my mom has a meeting with the lawyers about changing the custody schedule with my little sisters. Which, that does need to be done, because the schedule that we have now is absolute bullshit. It pretty much sucks. I just hate riding the damn bus. I have to get up an hour earlier than usual. Just to get to school, you know, early. And I have first period off. So I'm sitting there for, like... Well, first of all, I have to sit there for about 45 minutes... on two buses. Then, you know, after the buses... Hang on, let me think what to do here. Okay. After the buses, I'm sitting in the school for an hour doing nothing. And I know that that would be a really good time to, you know, just mess around, draw, maybe go on the internet, do whatever I want to do, but, you know, school internet, for one thing, is not so great. Plus, they have, like, almost all my sites blocked on there, so I can't do much anyway. And explain to me what in the L kind of sense it makes. Please, somebody explain what kind of sense it makes to block DeviantArt, and FurAffinity, and Tumblr, and YouTube, and pretty much any email site, but not InkBunny. School? Not sure if you noticed this, but InkBunny is basically the same thing as FurAffinity, only it's worse, because it allows cubs, and probably about half the site is underage content just because of that. So, that's just kind of hilarious. But the other thing is, like, early in the morning, I never feel like doing anything. I'm, like, tired and bored. I'm not really, like, awake yet, so I pretty much never feel like drawing early in the morning. It's not until I get going a bit later in the day that I feel like actually doing anything, which is part of the reason that I even have first period off in the first place. Alright, brick break on the Kangaskhan, and try attack on the Claydol should just about do it. So, I mean, sometimes in first period, if I get really bored, then I'll force myself to draw. But... that makes me lose a lot of my motivation to do anything later on in the day if I force myself to do something in the morning. That bayonet is so tempting. I love bayonet, but... I already have a ghost type, and I've got, like, freaking... How many dark types? I think I have only two, but that is enough. If I caught that bayonet and kept it, my team would be the most unbalanced team that there is, other than teams that use only one type. In fact, it might even be more unbalanced than that in some cases. You can have, like, a team of nothing but water types and still include so many different kinds of types. I know this because I actually, a while back... Back when Gen 5 was somewhat new-ish, I had beat the game, and I wanted to start doing competitive battling. I made myself a team for every type of Pokemon that there is. So I had, like, one all-normal team, one all-ghost, one all-fire, one all-dragon, and everything. All the types. It took a long time, but I did it. And, you know, once Gen 6 is released, I'm gonna have to redo those teams. Especially since I found out that I kind of Eevee trained them a bit wrong. Yeah. I also have a legendary team that is a team of nothing but legendaries, which to me, that's the only time it's really okay to use legendaries. If both participants use nothing but that, then it's okay because then it's an even playing field. But if you're gonna use legendaries against my regular team, well, that's a really unfair advantage. That you have. Excuse me, I need to sneeze. I need to sneeze, but I didn't sneeze. Fuck. I hate when that happens. The sneeze just, like, went away, so I just looked and sounded really stupid just then. Not looking forward to riding the bus in the morning. And I've been wanting to draw lately, too. I mean, maybe I'll feel like it. I'm drawing all my OCs as My Little Pony characters. Like, what their designs would look like as that. I used to be kinda into the show for a little bit during, like, season one. But then, you know, the more it went on, the more I lost interest. What's this? Donw with CIPHET. Okay. Oh, what the... Dear Michael, hello, this is my first email. I'm sorry that I sent an empty message by mistake. I also apologize for the misspellings. I'm embarrassed by these mistakes and what... Wait. You're telling me that the PDA has only one page of text on it and you can't scroll any further than that? In the year 2004? Okay, that device is absolute bullshit then. I mean, if you can't even do that, or like it doesn't even send the rest of the message that got cut off as separate emails, that's absolute bullshit. I mean, right now, yeah, that's really absolute bullshit, but even in the year 2004, a device like that, ugh. That's so bull. But whatevs. No bucks. Can I get that item? I would like to. Two revives. Yes, that is good for me. What was I talking about before? Oh yeah. Ugh, the My Little Pony show. Yeah, after about halfway through season two, I really started to lose interest in it. I mean, probably one of the main reasons I lost interest in it was because they started adding, like, more and more songs all the damn time, and I didn't like a single one of them. Some of them in season one I would find tolerable, but I wouldn't want to listen to them. I would just kind of, like, tolerate it. But, I mean, my god, the amount of songs lately, holy shit, that shit is annoying. Stop it. I guess that would probably be the main actual reason I have for losing interest in it. The other is just that I guess it didn't really hold my interest long enough. Like, you know, the novelty of it was really cool when it came out, but probably the main thing I even liked about it in the first place was the visual style and how fun the characters are to draw, which isn't quite enough to keep me interested in watching a show and following it. Especially when I have, like, other shows and stuff that I already watch and a lot of other things to keep up with. So, it just wasn't worth it to me. I still do a hello! I still occasionally draw the characters, but not very often. Only when I feel like it. I've seen a couple of OC designs for My Little Pony that I really like. Although I'm not really sure if they, like, break the rules of the fandom. Because, well, ever since I left it, I don't really know much about the rules of the fandom anymore. It's also hilarious over the internet when bronies get all, like, pissed about something that happened in the show and they make a giant deal out of it and there's, like, memes and everything and I'm like, oh my god, who the fuck cares? Calm your tits, it's just a show. I mean, like, the whole thing with, Twilight becoming a princess. Like, and an alicorn. Apparently their word for a pegasus and a unicorn is an alicorn. Which, I don't know if that's a word that they came up with, or if it's the actual legit word for that, but I find that word dumb. I always thought it was called a pegacorn. I don't know. Anyways, like, yeah, there was a huge uproar over that, and I'm just like, really? Why the hell does it matter? Like, so many people were so pissed about that. Like, to extremes, and I'm like, why does it matter? It doesn't. Even if I was still a fan of the show, I don't see why that would matter. I just, like, what significance does that have? As long as they don't completely change her, like, personality and shit. And, you know, things like that, and she's not totally different, then a design change isn't so much. Especially when it's not a complete overhaul. Pretty much all they would have to do is add, like, what, a tiara and wings? I don't see what the big problem is with that. Then again, I guess I don't really know. I'm not, like, with it enough to know about it, but I don't know, I just found that whole uproar thing to be pretty annoying after a while. I was just like, will you all just shut up about it? It cannot be that big of a deal, it really can't. Shadow Pincer, I don't want that. I don't want that Magmar either. So I'm just gonna get rid of them both. And I can do so quite easily. Again, I'm noticing that the levels in here are climbing pretty fast. Like, usually what would happen is that there would be a level range of about 3. Like, a window of 3. So, say maybe, like, level 32 to 35-ish. And it would just stay within that for a long time in most areas. But here, it's just, like, getting a bit higher each time. Like, we've gone from level 30s to level 36s here in the same area, and we're not even halfway done, I don't think. Anyways, we've gone a little bit over our usual 20 minutes, so I'm gonna stop it here. That is it for this episode of Let's Play Pokemon XD Gale of Darkness. In the next one, we're gonna go in that room, see what's in there. Yeah, and until then, goodbye, sir.